The Leadership Forum to launch the leadership strategies in southwestern Uganda was organized under the theme, The Private and Public Life of an Effective Leader. Kajina, while delivering her presentation, told leaders that there is no way they can live a totally private life without being accessed.
So where are you planted and what is it like? And have you done anything to change it, or have you agreed also to say, let me put myself in a closet, cover myself so that me, I am safe. You are never safe after as long as you stand alone. You're never. So I have always believed that where God has planted me, that ground must change.
She asked leaders to always cause a positive impact whenever God places them to serve community.
You see a man of God standing powerful and tall, winning millions to the Lord, he has a powerful private life. And may God help us to focus on our private lives so that our public lives win souls for God, change our nation.
Kajina revealed that for every man to succeed in this world entirely depends on how he or she conducts his or her private life, which reflects the public life.
When does he reach out to that person who is looking up to you and thinking, I can never be that person, and yet God wants that person? Do you understand me? So God knocked me and I was on my back for weeks, weeping and asking God for mercy, saying, God, may I never be bigger than you in any situation. Because if people don't see God and they see me, I have failed.
She reminded the leaders that the world can build someone's public life and assume that he or she is powerful.
The world can build your public life and you think you are very powerful. It's very tempting when everybody is calling you, worshiping you. You know, in you, the honored seat, it can go to your head. So who is that man or that woman that goes deep to say, this person is in trouble, let me go help minister to them and build their character, their private life? First of all, our leaders, especially our political leaders, are very busy running this country, right? Extremely busy. And they get tired. They are just like me and you, flesh and blood. They are all over the place. Doing this, doing that. Everybody's inviting them for fundraising and opening this.
Bishop Sheldon Mwesigwa, the Bishop of Ankole Diocese, said that the workshop has enlightened him as a leader to be flexible in whatever he does in the course of his work.
Yet challenge Yaman Yanat Terum Himbo Nong.
They encourage leaders to become Christ-like servants who impact nations by modeling integrity and reverence for God in their workplaces and family. Report compiled by Adolf Ayurika for the news.